Hi Neha, please introduce yourself to the audience.
Hi everyone, myself Niranjan Sahu. I am from Bhubaneswar, Odisha. I did my BTech from IGIT Sarang, Odisha only. I passed out, completed my BTech in 2016. Then I took 1 year gap and joined IIC in 2017. And now only 12 days ago, I completed my master's and currently working with Citrix R&D in Bangalore.
So one thing that I remember from Nihar is when I met him for the first time in 2017, he was very nervous. He couldn't talk at all. So he was actually shivering, you know, when he met me for the first time. Like, actually, he was shivering. I mean, his hands were shaking. And even when I shook his hands, he was very shaking then. So now I could see a completely different Nihar. So I think the difference is, you know, after completing his master's from IAS, he became very confident now. He is speaking and he is smiling actually. Yeah. What brought that change in you, Nihar?
Change is definitely 2 years of that duration change did something like MTech experience. And that time I was shivering because like I was meeting you for the first time. So that respect and like because of that, like, and in front of nearly 400 people in that hall. So I have never like standard, like before that I have never encountered any such a big crowd. So in front of so many crowd and standing near to you.
So now can you address the crowd?
Yeah, like after so 2 years of...
Is there any difference in you, you know, before IAS and after IAS? Is there any change in your perspective towards life or...
Towards life a lot actually, like during 2 years of IIC, like I learned a lot about life, not only about like computer science and all, about life I learned a lot how to like face the pressure situation.
Great, and even now I don't know about life still now.
That's like overall learning process. It's at some time it's not like you learn completely. So you improve every...
But you feel that there is a change in
yeah,
you.
There is a change, yeah. There is a
not
change.
Just in terms of academics, but
even in terms of life.
Life.
Also.
So you are looking at life in a different perspective.
Yeah, yeah.
So that is what happens. Great then. So now let's talk about your GATE preparation. So after your BTech, you had taken 1 year gap.
Yes.
And you prepared for GATE, right? You have registered in June, that is what we see in the records. Mm-hmm. But you were saying that you didn't start your preparation from June, right? What happened?
Like there were some personal problems, so I could not start. Like June was completely wasted, so I started from July.
So you effectively started
from July.
July, and you were able to dedicate a lot of time.
Yes.
So how many hours you used to prepare when you prepared for GATE every day?
Every day, in the sense, for initial 3-4 months, I was giving roughly 5 to 6 hours every day.
5 to 6. How was your schedule? How did
schedule
you make use
like,
of the videos?
I am not a morning guy, so even if you told in one video to start from 4 a.m., I could not do that. So I used to wake up around 8 or 9, so then 1 or 2 hours in the morning before lunch, then evening 1 or 2 hours, then before sleeping 1 or 2 hours, kind of that. That was the 3 phases I have divided for during preparation.
How did you make your notes while watching the videos?
Yeah, that was important actually. While watching the videos, I used to go through all those, like whatever videos I am going through, I will complete those videos once.
Okay.
Then what I'll do, like, so I'll figure out whatever you are writing on the board or whatever things you didn't write on the board, but it's important to make note. So while watching, like I used to watch those videos second time with like 2x speed or 1.5x speed. While watching second time, I used to make notes like whatever you have mentioned on the board, same thing.
So first time you use the audio completely?
Completely and video. Figure out what are the important points to be noted.
And second time you watch it at double the speed and you can so
note those things.
So one important thing that you can note is while watching the video for the first time, just concentrate completely on the video without writing anything down, and you can actually have download a plugin. You can email us, we'll send you the plugin. So using that plugin, you can play the videos at twice the speed. Second time when you're watching the video at double the speed, you can actually write down the notes. Okay, And while writing down the notes, did you do it in a very detailed way, or it was like short
notes? I used to actually do in very detailed way. Like first of all, I will complete all those notes you have mentioned on the board.
Okay.
Then whatever you are telling, like if I am going through note in second time, like 1 month later or 2 months later, I need to understand what I have written. So I was like writing the explanation of those board things, actually what you have written on board. In words I used to explain them on my own.
Okay, so you used to have a detailed notes.
Yeah.
So the notes used to be very lengthy.
Yeah, I used to be very lengthy actually.
And you used it for your revision.
Yeah, for detailed notes will be definitely required for revision. If you are not writing detailed notes, like only formulas and all, you cannot like understand from second time or third time you are seeing them. While doing revision, you cannot understand from where this equation comes and all those things are there.
So how was the notes useful? So did you use the notes even after your GATE preparation also?
Yeah, like for mathematics, like linear algebra, probability notes, I have used after
in masters.
During masters, during start
for the course.
Start semester of my masters, and algorithm and what else? I don't remember using other notes. These two notes I have used.
Algorithm and mathematics. And coming to this, people say that IASC is very mathematics, oriented, and you need to have in-depth knowledge about mathematics in order to survive at IASC. Is it true, or you can survive even without having mathematical skills?
Yeah, mostly mathematics is required. Like it also depends in which area you are working on, in machine learning area or theoretical area. Like mathematics is must.
So it is mainly discrete mathematics, right?
Mainly discrete mathematics, your logics, and for ML area, calculus and linear algebra, these two are must. You should have good understanding on those subjects. And if you are working in systems area, but in that area you can compromise on mathematics, but in theoretical and machine learning area, mathematics knowledge is very good. Mathematics knowledge is required actually.
Okay. Fine, so you have, then what about the test series? So did you take the test series while preparing?
Like I started preparation from July, but I started test series from August actually, because like what I was doing is like I was completing one subject, then corresponding to that subject, if test series was like already open, then I used to complete those test series so that I can test myself like whether I have did the revision properly or for that subject or not.
Okay. So generally what happens is our test series is very tough compared to the actual GATE exam, and many people, they are not able to score well. I mean, we intentionally make it happen that way so that they will give more time for revision, and also they will get used to writing a tougher test compared to GATE. Now, how did you do in your test series when you were preparing?
From initial test series, like kind of CO, OS, those subjects, like I was also struggling from initial test, like topic test. So I remember in one our computer organization test, I scored 4 out of some 33 or 35.
So 4 marks out of 33 or 35,
even like I was completely like demoralized, like what I'm doing, like. Then I realized what I was doing, the mistake, what mistakes I have made during that test. First was like kind of time management, then I was not reading the questions properly. I was like haphazardly I'm reading the questions. So because of that, I was missing some important points from the questions. So I learned that on the go actually while writing more and more topic test and multi-subject test. And then those tests, like there are kind of 135 tests I remember. So while writing those many tests on the go, and towards the end I learned like all those things, how to manage times and how to read questions properly, which questions to skip at that point and do those questions at the end. That you have to do smartly actually. You'll learn that while writing so many tests.
So one thing I'll tell you about Nihar is he never performed very well in test series. He was never in the top 10 or anywhere. But what he is saying is if you take a test series more and more, you will be able to learn about the time management and the and how to read the questions. So you will be able to make a lot of mistakes in the test series itself, that you could avoid those mistakes in the final exam, right? So if you take more tests, you'll be able to make more mistakes and you'll be able to make less mistakes in the final exam. So keeping that in mind, so what we are doing now is, so we are actually giving you 80 tests in the test series, but apart from it, we are also releasing the 2019 test series also. So for GATE 2020, you are already getting one test series for which you have paid the fee. Apart from it, along with it, for free, we are giving you 2019 test series as well. So you can actually take 80 plus 80, 160 tests. So the more tests you take, the more you'll be benefited. Okay, so don't worry about the marks. There, for sure, no one has actually performed well in all the test series. Even he got 4 marks, 5 marks like that in many test series. So don't worry about it. So eventually you are going to get a good rank. But just keep learning and just keep taking tests. So start off tests as early as possible. He started taking tests from August itself. Okay, so now we are actually in the mid-July. So probably this is the right time for you to start preparation. He started his preparation in, you know, July ending like that. So it is the right time to start your preparation and also start taking your test series. And while taking the test series, you follow the timetable that is already given in the test series. Okay, so what I mean to say is, you follow the timetable according to the test series, you prepare your subjects also, and after finishing every topic, you take a test. Okay, now that you are given 2 tests for every topic, you can take 1 test while preparation and other test while revision. Okay, so you can use the test series that way.
And right? Another point also, like assessing your test is also important. Like even if I am performing good or bad in a test, like everyone should go through those solutions and all. Even if you are doing good in that test, like even if you have scored 30 out of 33, don't ignore that, like, I have scored 30, so I will not waste time going through solutions. Going through solutions sometimes helps, because in solutions sometimes you'll find like better, like time saving solutions as compared to your approach. So if you'll go through, like if you have multiple approaches to solve one kind of questions during final test or main test, if you are not able to like do it in one way, one approach, you can go like use another approach. So go through solutions also. Even if you are doing well, if you are not doing well, definitely go through solutions. Even if you are doing well, also go through the solutions. That will help to improve yourself.
So he is saying that even if you are done with your test series, whether you did good or bad, you just go through the solutions so that you will know the approaches that we are using, and you'll know the approach that you have used. So it is always better to, you know, look at the problem from various perspectives. So that is one good thing. Okay. And did you read any standard textbooks while preparing for GATE, or did you stick only to the videos?
As I said, I started from July, so I didn't have much time to go through all the textbooks. So I only watched those videos, then I prepared my own notes, then revision and test series and previous questions, and in our time also practice sets were there, so those practice sets, all those things. I have not gone through rigorously any textbooks at all. So even if you have some very less time before GATE exam, don't go through textbooks. Videos are really enough, like for preparation and all.
So what he is trying to say is, as you are having enough time. See, if you are starting from July, if you know you are actually covering a lot of syllabus in just a few months, so you are not having 4 years time. So if you are starting your GATE preparation from your first year onwards, I recommend that you read some books. But if you are starting your preparation in July, August like that, you will not have a lot of time to read all the textbooks. So I suggest that just stick to the videos. Textbooks are not really going to help you here. So you know, even if you read textbooks, it is not about how much you read, it is about how much you remember by the end. So that is why you just try to remember everything that you read. So if you stick to videos, if you stick to our test series, if you stick to our practice questions, you will definitely get 80 to 90% of the marks only from the videos. Okay, so you need not do a lot of work apart from it. And one more mistake that I'm normally seeing from people is, initially when they start, you know, for the first few months they'll be very very motivated, mm-hmm. and they don't want to leave out anything, mm-hmm. so they don't want to make any mistakes, mm-hmm. so they want to be perfect with what they are doing. So for the first subject, they will read everything possible. they will read the textbook and they will watch the video, they will do everything,
mm-hmm.
but only to realize that they have wasted too much time on one subject.
Mm-hmm.
So what they are trying to do is they are trying to do PhD in the in gate preparation. So see, you can do a lot of research in a subject, but that is not really required for gate.
Target, actually, yeah, that's the true fact, sir, is saying like go through like in depth knowledge about any particular subject is not required at all for GATE. Like in depth, like actually there are different sub subjects in a particular subject we are going through in during GATE. Like if going through operating system, in operating system there are some different areas also altogether. During MTech we can research in those areas. So in operating system, whatever required for GATE, like in videos you will get everything. So no need to go through different books, multiple books, reading books. Even if in every book there will be different subjects, you don't know exactly which subjects are required for GATE, which are not. So in videos, like all are compiled in one stage, so they're properly compiled as per the requirement of for GATE preparation. So as per my view, like videos are really enough.
So we did our research and we have taken the topics which are really helpful. You don't know which topics to stress on and which topics to leave. So that is why, you know, reading textbooks is not going to help. And, you know, anyway, in your masters, you are going to do research. So now GATE is all about knowing something in everything. It is not about knowing everything in something.
Yeah, it's kind of breadth knowledge.
It is compared to
depth knowledge in masters.
So you need to learn, know about all the topics, a little about all the topics. You need not know everything about a particular topic. So you should actually be very smart spending time, because you are not going to, no one can actually put in 10 hours of time every day. So even if you know, even when he prepared full time for GATE, he was able to just put 4 to 5 hours per day. That is the maximum anyone could spend. So you need to optimize. So you need to learn as much as possible in that time. So don't waste your time doing a lot of research. Don't be a perfectionist. Don't try to get full marks in, don't aim. See, it is good to aim for full marks in test series, but don't get disappointed if you don't get full marks in the test series. No one is able to do that. Okay, so don't have your target very high. You will get disappointed. Either when you take it to the, you know, preparation time, you are not going to spend, you might not be able to spend more than 4 to 5 hours a day. That is fine, that is enough. And if you are talking about the test series, you might not be able to score 100% marks. That is fine. Okay, so don't have to, you know, don't push yourself too far and don't get disappointed. So if you are doing normal, that is okay. Okay, fine.
I'll add one point actually. Like putting high target is fine, but don't put high target like for first week or second week. You can put high target after 2-3 months. I'll score this much. I should score at least 60-70 out of 100, kind of that. Initially, you have to experience what are the things actually. Only you are reading. You don't know how to solve the questions in real time actually during that stipulated half an hour time or 3 hours of time. So that thing you should not be worried about initially. You learn, practice, revise, put targets for like after 4 or 5 months or 3 months if you have less time. So initially no need to put very high target for initial few tests.
Okay, start off small and then you can increase it.
Yeah,
that is what he's saying. And the next thing is, coming to previous year GATE questions, try to go through all the previous year GATE questions while preparing the topics. And don't take, so we are intentionally not covering 2016, 2017 and 2018 questions. Okay, so from 2016 onwards, don't solve the GATE question papers, because I want to give you these the tests as a test series. You can take even these tests as a test series. So try to solve the GATE questions before 2016 exam. And from GATE 2016, 17, 18, we are going to give you all this also as a part of the test series. So this will be included apart from the 80 tests which you have paid for. We are giving you GATE 2019 test series as well as the previous year GATE questions also. We are going to give you as a test series. So please don't try to read these questions or solve these questions beforehand. You can use them as a test series part and you will get benefited. You will know how the actual GATE question paper is when you. So then you scored A or 9. Okay, and the most important question is, now you had the two choices then. One is you could have gone to IIT Bombay, or you know, the other one is IISc, and you had chosen IISc. So now the question, the most popular question people asking is, Which one is better? So why did you choose IASC instead of IIT Bombay?
Which one is better, I cannot tell because I have gone through IASC only. I can tell about IASC. So better, Himadri would have told about IIT Bombay. So then about IASC, why I joined, like I was inclined towards research from childhood. So I didn't know initially about IASC, but during my second year I remember of BTEC, like I got to know that IASC is a good research institute in India, and they are also well placed among all other world famous research institutes. So then I tried, like I thought about joining IASC, then I gave GATE and I got this score. I didn't even apply for IIT Bombay. IASC was my only option because I was inclined towards research.
So people say that IASC is more inclined towards research, and most of the courses also are designed in that way. So in most of the courses, when you take a course, the curriculum will be discussing the research papers. Instead of taking a standard textbook, they will start getting the papers to classes, and they will just discuss the papers in the class, research papers, and they will also give you some research papers as assignments. Okay, we'll talk about it soon.
And recently also IASC was ranked 2 among all research institute in terms of papers and all research papers publications.
Okay, so it is mainly about research. I mean, see, coming to placements, both are more or less the same.
Yeah.
So almost you are getting the same packages either in IIT Bombay or in IASC, and anyway the companies are mainly from Bangalore, so eventually you are going to move to Bangalore. Okay.
That's
so
true.
Yeah, most of the people even from IIT Bombay also move to Bangalore or Hyderabad. So the only difference is in terms of the research. That is what I feel. So we don't have any experience in IIT Bombay, so we can't talk about IIT Bombay, but what we feel is IASC is better in terms of research. That is what we can say. And the next thing is, given the chance now, with all the knowledge that you have now, will you take the same decision again if you have to make it?
Yeah, I'll go for IAS. Even if someone will ask like whether IIT Bombay or IAS, I'll choose IAS only because of those 2 years of good experience I got from IAS.
So you're missing IAS now?
Yeah, definitely. Like I left IAS, like my last day was 29th of last month, so it's been 10-12 days now. I miss a lot. I see my IIC friends, the environments in IIC, everything about IIC I miss.
So with AR9, you'll also be getting some PSUs also, right?
Yeah.
So why did you apply for PSUs and why did you choose Masters? Even they are paying a good amount.
If you are choosing PSU, like your area will be fixed, like you cannot come to Masters after 2-3 years, PSU will lose interest about doing more studies and all. So if you want to explore about some area, particularly if you want to know what are the real options in computer science, you should go for Masters and explore the areas. After Masters also you can PSU, your PSU option is not blocked if you are doing Masters. So I'll suggest don't go for PSU directly after GATE. If you are getting good rank and you are able to get some good colleges, go for Masters, explore there. Then if you don't like corporate life, then you can come back to PSU. There are some pressures from family and all, that happens generally. So directly going for PSU is not a good option.
So now let's talk about the coursework.
Mm-hmm.
So how was the coursework in IASC?
IASC for our department, computer science department, actually everyone has to complete 40 credits. That's compulsory, but courses are not compulsory. In terms of course, IASC has divided all the courses into 3 pools, and there is one advanced pool also. So those 3 pools are basically theoretical pool, and then systems pool, and intelligent systems. Machine learning comes under intelligent systems. In theoretical pool, there are subjects related to algorithms and cryptography are there. Then systems related to OS, CO, all those things. In machine learning, mostly like linear algebra, probability, those are basic things. Then machine learning, reinforcement learning.
So what is the minimum requirement in every pool?
In our time when we joined, there was like 2 pool courses for every pool. Like, so 2 courses from every pool, so there are 6 subjects. Then rest four subjects you can do from any pool or any other department also. That's completely free. Like there is no restriction that you have to do only from CSE department. So you can, even I did two courses from electrical department also. So that was still our joining batch, but from now on, I think there are 43 credits everyone has to complete. And those six pool courses you have to complete during first year itself. That's the one restriction they have put now from this batch. So apart from those six courses, rest five courses to complete 43, you have to do rest five courses. So rest five courses you can take from advanced pool or any other department or CSE department itself. That's your own choice. But what happens, generally people do those five courses in their research area. Like I was in machine learning area, so I took machine learning related courses to explore more about machine learning and data science. So if someone is doing in OS, they will take related to OS related areas like that. That happens generally.
So what he's saying is there is no fixed curriculum. Like you need not take, the courses are not fixed. So you'll have a pool of courses and you are supposed to choose subjects from the pool, and that depends on your interest. So actually there are all the subjects are divided into three pools. One is the theory. Theory means you'll mainly get subjects like algorithms, data structures, and graph theory and game theory. All these things will be
Game theory is intelligent systems.
And then the cryptography, and what are the other subjects in theory?
These three are mostly there only.
Okay. And then the other pool is you have intelligent systems. Intelligent systems means all the things related to machine learning. So when the courses like probability, statistics, and optimization techniques, and in all these things, data mining, machine learning, web mining, all these courses come in the intelligent systems. And then the systems course pool is there, which mainly deals about the systems topics. So like operating systems, compiler design, databases, all these system related courses will be in that pool. Now the requirement is you are supposed to do 10 courses in your 2 years. You can do them anytime. 10 courses in these 2 years, but you are supposed to do at least 2 courses from each pool, right? So which means 6 courses you are supposed to take from these 3 pools. And apart from it, the remaining 4 subjects you can choose from any pool, or even you can also take it from any other department, right? And now coming to these 4 subjects, generally people take them in such a way that these courses will be helpful for them in the project. For example, if you are, you know, if your interest is to work in the machine learning area, you generally take these 4 courses from the intelligent systems pool so that you will broaden your knowledge in that area. Right, so it is very important that you fix your area before you join your masters and try to take as many courses as possible in that area. You know, you are supposed to credit all these 10 courses. So see, if you don't want to if you are able to credit all these 10 courses and if you still want to learn more courses, then you can audit them.
Yeah, like 40 is also a minimum criteria. You can credit more also.
Yeah, so 10 subjects. So see, 10 courses are there and 40 credits for them, which means every course is going to carry 4 credits. You are supposed to finish 40 credits by the end of 2 years, but if you want, you can even do more. But the problem is, as you do more and more courses, there is a chance that your CGPA might come down,
or you cannot focus on your projects also.
Because there will be a lot of assignments. So instead of creating, you can audit. So you can just go and sit in the classroom. You need not do the assignments. You can just learn from the teaching of the faculty. You need not actually write the exams, or you need not actually submit the assignment. That is called auditing. Okay. And the marks will not get reflected in the curriculum. I mean, in your this certificate. And how difficult were the courses?
Courses like that depends. Like mostly courses will be tough, like in terms of, because there are many assignments and midterms and final exams. In some like subjects, projects are also.
So there. How many assignments will be there for each course?
Minimum of 2 assignments.
Two assignments and one project.
1 midterm minimum.
Okay.
Then project is kind of optional. If there will be 2 options, like final exam or project. If you choose project, then you have to do the project. If you choose final exam, then you have to write the final exam.
Oh, that is option given to everyone.
Not for every subject. There are many subjects. This
varies from subject to subject.
But in many subjects, these options are available.
So how difficult is it to score good marks there?
Difficult in the sense, if like it is open book exam, then it's really tough because questions will be like out of box completely. Like people, like professors give 8 hours, 9 hours to solve those questions. Open book,
generally
open
you
internet.
Go to the exam in the morning after having breakfast.
Yeah,
and you can.
And they will give snacks also
in middle.
In middle also. So
for 8 hours you are supposed to sit there and finish the exam.
So this is for one or two subjects, and there are other open books exam. Like time is fixed. In 3 hours you have to finish, but you can take any books, any notes, anything. You can take two exams, and closed book exams are little easy to score. Like those subjects you should target. Like if you want to improve your grades, closed book subjects will help you. An open book subject, you will learn more, you will experience new things, but scores will not be that easy to get.
So why is CGPA very important?
CGPA is important kind of if you are going for PhDs and all, then in some universities they put some CGPA thresholding criteria. And in during placement also, like some companies, like not all, like 4 or 5 companies will have some CGPA criteria. If you have good CGPA, that's always better. That reflect your like profile. This guy has good CGPA. And that too in CGPA in IIC, like really good. Like someone has 8 plus CGPA in IIC, like.
So now it is grading is for 10, right?
Yeah, this is out of 10. Yeah.
So when I was doing, it was for 8.
Yeah, now also people think that it is out of 8, but it has changed.
No, it is good, right? People are thinking that it is out of 8, and if you have 7 out of 10, they'll think it is 7 out of 8.
But we have to mention what is the maximum CGPA. There is a field for maximum CGPA. We cannot fool them.
Great. So now that, you are saying that only for few companies CGPA matters,
yeah.
And for most of the companies
it is flexible,
right? So roughly if you can get 60% out of 60% marks, then it is you can get to many of the companies.
Yeah, 60% in the sense marking in IIC all the subjects it's relative. So like even if you are scoring 20 out of 100, but if high score is 40, so that's kind of considered as 50 or something like that.
So relative scoring is much better compared to absolute scoring. So actually IIC follows the relative grading system. Most of the subjects they follow relative grading. Only few subjects they
very
follow.
Very few, one or two books.
Yeah, one or two have this absolute grading system.
Grade.
So in relative grading system, the advantage is if the highest mark is just 40 out of 100, then the 100 comes down to 40. So from there they are going to grade it that way. Okay,
no need to judge 40 out of 100. Questions are really kind of that hard.
Yes, so he's saying that if someone gets 40 out of 100 in IIC, so don't think that they are not doing well. So even if people do well, still they'll end up there. That is what he's saying. So that is about your coursework. So let's talk about your normal life at IIC. So apart from coursework, so how is the life at IISc? How are your hostels?
Hostels are pretty good actually. Like if I'll compare with my previous hostels and all, like hostels are pretty good and mess were also pretty good. And life at IISc, like initial days.
Were you given a single room or sub? Or
yeah, it is single room.
Do you have to share
the room? No, single room only.
So all the
masters and PhD, everyone has single room only. And room size is also big enough for a single person. And life in
the most of the institutes, even in IIT and NITs also, for especially for boys, and the rooms are like single and separate rooms for everyone.
Yeah, yeah.
But for girls, they need to share.
Yeah, girls hostel, like they are building new hostels. So like after 1 or 2 years also, it will be single.
Okay. So rooms were good and
rooms
separate.
And sanitation is there, like every day like workers will come and clean.
So there will be room cleaning and all.
Room cleaning and all.
And how was the food at IISc?
Food.
So you are from Orissa, right?
Yeah, I am from Orissa. So like food in terms of like there are 4 messes in IISc.
Is there any mess related to Orissa food?
Yeah.
There are 4
like
messes, right?
4 messes. 2 are like North Indian. So North Indian base, North Indian non-base. These 2 messes. Then South Indian base, South Indian non-base. So all these are 4 messes. So like depending on their locality, people generally choose. So I don't prefer veg a lot, so I am in North Indian non-veg for both the years. So like foods are good, like North Indian non-veg, like if you see the name, it is North Indian, but mostly those mess community people are from West Bengal, so West Bengal Odisha food general matches, so I never had any problem.
There is one mess is especially dedicated to West Bengali food.
No, that North Indian non-veg is called Bengali because 70 to 75% people in that mess is from West Bengal only. They don't go to other messes generally.
And it will be Bengali food.
Mostly. Yeah, because mess community people are from Bengali, so they will put items.
So food also, you didn't had any problem. Yeah. So were you homesick because you were?
No. I was not that homesick because my hostel life started from 2012. So.
Achha. So you are already used to it.
Yeah.
Already anyway, used. I don't think that you had time to be homesick now.
Yeah, exactly.
Right from the day you start, you joined IASC. I think you need to register for the courses. You will be running here and there, submitting the forms and registering.
No,
the
other things are also there. Like if you want to go home, I will not name, but there are friends. During those 2 years, they have gone to their home like 20-30 times.
20-30 times.
It's like if you want to find time, you can find time. It's not like that.
Depending on the courses you take,
and depending on your own time management, how you are managing time. That's the most important thing. If you are unable to manage time, you are putting everything at for the end time, then you will be stuck. If you are doing from day one every day, like 4 hours every day kind of thing, then you can manage time weekends, you can go home and all those things.
What were your timings like at IASC?
Timings like...
So when did you wake up, when you used to wake up and when...
Classes start generally from 8 a.m.
Okay.
So there are like optional, so there are many subjects.
So again, classes also depending on the courses that
yeah,
you
that's
take.
Yeah, that's what I am saying. Like, there are many subjects going on, so you have to choose some subjects. Some subjects will start from 8, some subjects like depending on their timing and professor's timing. So like whatever I took the subjects, like first 2 semesters classes were starting 8 a.m. I took those subjects only, those who are starting at 8 a.m. So then second half there are no classes, so the second half you can take rest. So if you are taking courses who are being done in second half, then you can take rest in morning half, or you can go for gym and sports and all.
So you had time to do all that?
In initial 2-3 months, I used to go for badminton every day the evening section, not morning, because morning I had class. So evening time, 2 hours badminton, I used to go every day. So after 2-3 months, final exams for 4 subjects came, so and projects in 2 subjects, so I could
so
not find time.
Couldn't find time.
Initially, you can find time, but while you will do go deeper into the semester. It's a little hard to find time.
So when did you finish your placements?
Placements happened last year in October end.
October
end.
So which means you were in the third semester?
Third semester. Mid of third semester, we finished our... We were done with our placements.
So once you are done with the job, you are free?
After placements are done, final thesis will be there. So you have to work on research areas and all. Because till placements, all the coursework and preparations will be there. So you have to focus more time on your thesis and all. During that time, you can find time for sports and games, and because only thesis will be there.
Okay.
So that's the time people generally prefer to go for sports. Before that, they focus on their coursework, how to get good grades.
Okay.
So that's final semester is the good time for exploring IASC for masters.
Okay. So during the nights you had parties there?
Yeah, quite a time.
So parties in this as normal parties?
Normal parties also.
Just like birthday parties.
Birthday parties, yeah. We used to go a group of 20-30 people to some restaurant to have parties and come back.
I think you have a restaurant inside the campus, right?
Inside campus, actually, now food points, there are 1, 2, 3, 4 food points.
4 food points apart from the mess.
Apart from the mess.
So one is at the faculty hall, you have one.
Mm-hmm.
And the Nesara you have, and Prakruti you
Prakruti
have.
Prakruti and new one is Tattva.
Tattva, okay. So
near
this
that D gate.
Acha. So do you have anything near that Gymkhana?
Gymkhana, there is one restaurant that is Gymkhana Cafe, we call. That's for night time only.
Night time, you generally.
Yeah, evening to 2 a.m., 3 a.m.
Okay. So you generally sleep at 2 3 2 a.m.
Yeah, I am not a morning person, so
yeah, I think most people do that there. And
yeah, most people prefer because night time is like silent, they can study, like no one will be there to disturb them.
During our time we used to have a server where they put all the new movies.
Uh-huh.
So they host all the new
DC
movies.
Plus is still there.
It is still there. So what about the piracy problem and all?
So I have never used DC Plus Plus during the last 2 years, so I cannot tell much about that.
There are people who download movies from those servers. And they just watch the movies inside the campus itself.
Yeah. Even if like in our classroom, we host India matches, cricket matches, or football matches, or famous football matches also.
Oh, in the department itself.
In the night time, no one asks, like professors will not be there.
So you project the...
Yeah, we project those matches
and
big screen, yeah.
Big screen. Oh, great. That is one other development that I am listening now. So
security guards are really friendly in our department. So if you ask from like room key, they will give. After 2 3 months, they will be used to us. Like we are friends now.
Okay.
So they will not deny like giving keys or that.
So you had a lot of fun.
Yeah. A lot of fun during those 2 years, a lot of learnings also.
So coming to placements, there are many misconceptions. People think that the marks from 10th class plus 2 and BTEC, they really affect the placements. Is it true that these marks affect?
No, it is not completely, like it's not at all actually, it's not at all true. Even if we don't mention 10th, 12th percentage in our CV. So nobody is interested to go through like what is your percentage in 10th or 12th. Like even GATE marks does not matter. Like even if like someone is rank 1, someone is rank 900, like with some quota they went into IIC, that also does not matter. Only thing matter is like what's your grade in IIC and how you performed in those course projects and course exams. And what main thing is, what is your skill set that you are explaining during your interview. That's the only thing, that's the most important thing. And IIC grades are there, but 10th and 12th grades never matters.
So he's saying that even, for BTEC also, it is 55% is the minimum requirement.
For admission.
So IIC has only 55% requirement in your BTEC. So, your BTEC marks are plus 2 marks or 10th class marks. They really doesn't matter at all during your placement. Only thing that matters is, only for some companies, not for all the companies, they will check your master's CGPA, and some companies even will not look for master's CGPA also, but some of them will look at it. So if you perform well in your master's, that is good enough in order to sit for placements. And after, once you get into placements, it is again the same, right? So coming to your placement preparation, so was the GATE syllabus enough, or did you do any other preparation apart from it?
Yeah, like depends, like which area, like what is the profile of the companies. Like if you are into like only machine learning, then from GATE only linear algebra part will help, linear algebra and probability part will help. And if you are into some software development profile, then you like those interview preparations like about algorithm, how you do optimized algorithms, how you like design optimized algorithm, that will matter. Like for that, like kind of research video about interview preparation you can go through. Those are really good. Like if you are going through gigs per gigs, if you see that those questions, they have given solutions, but if you are unable to understand those solutions, like I have gone through his videos actually, those solutions he has explained like in very good way, like good, you can understand pretty easily. Like if you have gone through GATE preparation, you can understand like how well he is in explaining things. So he has explained in same way during it. Those videos are pretty helpful if you are looking for HD profile.
So you had taken the interview preparation course in 2017 only, no?
No, I took like 17.
After your GATE,
I wanted
break.
I wanted to, yeah, in those 2 months break, I wanted to explore what are the things I can do. So I took that video.
So one good thing he did was after his GATE exam was over, during that break, from the GATE exam till his admission time, he was having the time because he prepared full-time for GATE. So during that time, he has taken our interview preparation course also, and he finished it. So I think, you know, if for those who are seriously thinking about getting into masters, anyway, you are going to go to these interviews. And what we did is I collected all the questions that these companies generally ask, and I just generalized them into various categories, and I explained them, you know, at that level.
So, and that will also help. Like, I find few people, like there are few people and few friends also, they are afraid of coding and all. They don't know how to frame the algorithms and all. If they're going through those videos, that will help. If they're not good at coding initially, and that will help building their logics, and that will help definitely for placements.
See, my suggestion is just by heart those questions. There are standard questions mainly asked in these companies, and I have formed the videos using all those standard questions. You just by heart those questions, and you know, when they ask you a question, just act as if you have never heard about the question, right? Don't right away get on to the
yeah. That's the good strategy in during placement interviews.
Placement, yeah.
Don't directly like solve in optimized way. Start from very naive way.
Naive
like,
way.
O of n q algorithm, then go to n square, then to n log n kind of, you give your approach would be like that.
Even so, in my videos also I explained the same way. So we take the naive approach and we say that, you know, if you go by this approach, the time complexity is exponential, then we come to n square, then we come to n log n, and if possible we go to n. So what you are supposed to do is act as if you are seeing the question for the first time. If you directly jump onto the solution, they will definitely understand that you have seen the question earlier, and they will ask you a different question, and they'll keep asking you that. So it is better that you take time and you try to eat time on the questions that you know, and then you can easily get a job.
Yeah, so, like kind of one interview stage will be, there are multiple interview stages. In one interview
stage, how many phases you had in your interview? One is the
mine
test.
Is three round, or like apart from written round. So
written test is a normal.
So that's also depends what
depend
is the profile.
Profile
yeah, like in ML profile, linear algebra probability will be there, mostly probability will be there. And SD profile, get syllabuses and some 2-3 codings will be there. So in mostly like what is the maximum length of one stage, if one someone will ask, then that's kind of in IIC allowed maximum time for one round is 1 hour. Like our replacement cell has put that restriction on companies, they can take only maximum 1 hour for one round, and they can go up to 4 or 5 rounds for on-campus placement. So if you are starting from naive approach, that will eat time, as sir said. So easily for one question, you can take half an hour time, and you can show your approach also. They will be impressed by your approach. This guy is performing like slowly improving.
So I have even taken that in my mind, and that is how even I explained the questions in interview preparation course. So if you see the course, we start with the naive approach and then improvise, and finally at probably at fourth or fifth step we go to the actual solution. Now once you propose the actual solution, they will ask you to write the algorithm and they will ask you to analyze the time complexity. So if just by heart those algorithms, they are simple. The all the questions are standard. See, getting a job in a product-based company, once you get an interview call, it's very, very easy if you prepare those standard questions. Okay, so getting that interview call is the difficult part. Now, once you get into masters in these, you know, in these good companies, yeah, top tier colleges, so IITs, NITs, IIITs, you know, IISc, all these are, you know, top tier colleges. So you will definitely get a call from the you will definitely get the product-based companies interviews. And once you get it, cracking it is very easy. So don't worry about it. So because many people are asking me, so I'm telling you, for now, focus on GATE, get a rank. Getting a job is like a cakewalk, okay? So now one most commonly asked question is, will the age really matter? Some people say that I am already 30 years old and should I go for a master's now?
Mm-hmm.
And will I be considered the same like you know, other students? And some people will be having gap between their BTEC and masters.
Mm-hmm.
They might have done some jobs in service-based companies,
mm-hmm.
or they might have been completely idle for the time.
Mm-hmm.
So will
doing
it affect
something else.
Yeah, doing something else, or some people might have prepared for GATE for 2-3 years.
Yeah,
so will it really affect it during your this campus placement, or will they be
no,
treated?
Not at all. Placements, they don't see like what is your gap and like when did you do your BTEC. They didn't see, and they generally don't see at all. Like in our batch also 4 or 5 people are above 28.
Okay,
so all of them got good placed also, good placements. So it's BTech, which year you completed your BTech, that doesn't matter at all. And whatever you doing during those gap also, that also doesn't matter.
So even experienced people also will be considered the same.
Same thing.
Experienced or inexperienced.
Freshers, everyone.
Or years or marks, it all doesn't matter.
Doesn't matter.
Everyone will be treated equally.
Equally.
And they will be given the same salaries.
Only thing matter is what is your degree, M.Tech or Ph.D. That is the only thing matters. And for M.Tech, there is no age discrimination during M.Tech, or there is no age discrimination during Ph.D. also.
Okay.
People are there like 40 ages, they are doing PhD, they are 24 ages, they are also doing PhD, they are equally treated.
Everyone will be treated equally and the salaries will be same.
Yeah.
So it doesn't vary. And overall, how do you rate your life at IISc? So do you think that it is very hectic, or have you enjoyed your life? And
initially it will be little bit like, because during our BTechs, like generally, like if people are coming from like low tier colleges, then their life is very chill. So in IISc or IITs, whatever, you will go top tier colleges, the curriculum and all, there will be hectic, and you will be competing with top 50 students of India, so that is also there. So initially it will be hectic. After one or two semesters, you will be acquainted with all those systems, like how to manage with assignments, how to manage with midterms and final projects, like final subject projects. Then from third semester onwards, it will be a bit easy, and some semester onwards also coursework will be not there much. So
in second year you are able to get some time.
Yeah, get some time. Not exact all of the second year. Initial semester of second, like third semester, you will be busy for placements.
Placement preparation will be there.
And if you are like in some extracurricular, like in some member of some clubs, then there will be some activities of those clubs also.
What are the other clubs you have at IISc?
There are a lot of like game clubs, like cricket
club, football club,
all sports, outdoor sports like badminton, indoor, in terms of indoor badminton, TT is there, like outdoor cricket, football, hockey, basketball, volleyball, everything is there.
And yeah, I think we also have
music club is there, then travel club is there, yoga club is there, everything is there. It's all those clubs.
And how was the gymnasium there?
Gym is good, but I don't go for gym, so I can't say actually.
Okay. So you had all the facilities?
Yeah, all the facilities available. Then
go out of campus?
Going out, like during, after my placement till my last month, like I was part of 7 trips.
So
every weekend we used to go somewhere or other, like either lab mates or departments, or there is one Hindi Samhita also there, or
okay,
Hindi club kind of. They also organize trips in like once in 3 months kind of thing. So
you go on trips?
Yeah.
So you went on 7 trips after your placements?
After my placements.
So yeah. Probably after placements you got free and you enjoyed it?
Yeah, there are only one course and my research project.
Okay.
And
so you are able to get time?
Get time for roaming around Bangalore.
Oh, that's a great thing. So what is the job role that you have in Citrix?
I got SDE2 profile actually in Citrix R&D.
So SDE2.
SDE2 I got.
SDE2 means Software Development Engineer 2. So generally people, they take BTech people for 1 and M.Tech people for 2. And are you okay with that? Are you happy with that? Or are you planning on switching to some other company?
I was in my master thesis, I was working in ML area. So like I want to switch into some ML.
So ML role.
Related
so
roles.
You want to become some data scientist or something?
Not
applied scientist.
In terms of data scientist, data science researchers, I will say data science and research profile is bit
okay,
better
so
as compared to developers. There are also developer profiles in machine learning. So
I think then you can try for IBM IRL if you want a researcher post. IBM IRL will be. So do you have any plans of going for PhD, or are you planning on staying in India? And
yeah, as I had already told, I was inclined towards research from childhood.
Uh-huh.
So definitely plan is there. So
PhD
when I'll go, that depends on my paper actually, when it will be published.
Are you able to publish a paper in your master's?
Not yet. By September, I think it will be.
So ready. You have submitted the paper?
Paper will be ready to submit. So
okay, you'll submit it in September?
Yeah, now we're writing like fast draft kind of thing.
Okay. So you'll be publishing, submitting the
paper
in September, and probably it will get get published by January.
January, 3 months generally.
Yeah, basically. January. So for 1 year you are going to work in some job.
Yeah, minimum of 6 months, max 1 year.
Max is 1 year. For 1 year, probably you'll be working here in India, and then you'll be going for PhD after that.
Yeah.
So probably in US or.
I don't know exactly now. I'll try for some foreign universities.
Aiming for Stanford?
Yeah, that's there in option.
So your professor, where is
he? He's from Stanford University.
So he's from Stanford. Then it will be easy for you to get there.
Yeah, hope so.
So generally, if you are interested in going for PhD, it is better to find out a professor who is already from that university. So since his professor is from Stanford University, if he writes a recommendation letter, it will be easy for him to get into Stanford. So that is what his plan is. So he is going, he is trying for that. And are you going to stick to Citrix or are you going to switch a company?
So that I can't say now. Like even in Citrix also there are machine learning profiles inside there.
Okay, so you will apply for them.
Yeah, I'll try to switch in Citrix itself. If not, then I'll try for others.
So generally the trend is, when I did my master, the trend was we generally get a company in our campus interviews, but we'll apply for jobs off campus and then showing this this offer letter, we'll negotiate the salaries and whichever company generally
that happens. That happened in our batch also. Yeah. One guy got placed in one company with like kind of 30 or 33. But he negotiated with other companies in off campus, saying that I have already 33 offer, I need more than that. So he got 36.
Yeah, sometimes even go to 50 also. So people, in one of my batchmates, he did change 7 companies in 8 months or so. So people do that. So whichever company you get in your campus need not be your final offer.
In terms of like placement, if you're in computer science, it's really flexible. You can go anywhere. Like if you have right kind of skill set, then no problem.
See, if you have already prepared for placements and if you are in that in that zone, so you can easily answer any questions related to placement. So it is better that you try to attend as many interviews as possible when you are still having in that preparation phase, because after 2-3 years again, if you have to read all these things, it will be hectic. So since you are in that flow, just finish off all the interviews and then get the maximum. That, see, obviously one thing is you have to look at the job profile, and the second thing is the salary. So you have to keep trying so that you get the best out of these two. Okay, so that is about Nihar. So Nihar, any final words that you want to say? Or okay, there are a few more questions that I would like to ask. So coming to internships, so how are the internships at IISc? So were you allowed to take internships in your final year?
Internships actually started in our batch itself. Prior to that, there was no internship facility in IISc. Like that happens generally in during mid of second semester. So less number of companies, like around 15 to 20 companies will come for internships. They are now allowing every students. In our batch, they didn't allow every student also. Like some professors told that these students should be there in campus for research project and all, but from this batch they are allowing every student.
So for 2 months you can go for internship?
2 months is minimum, 3 months is maximum. Some companies need 3 months time, and they talk to professor that if like that company and professor are working in collaboration, they can allow for 3 months also.
Okay. So how is the startup culture at IISc? Is there any startups?
There are many startups from CSA department. But in our batch, no one has started anything yet. But there are, in history, if you will see, there are 7-8 startups from our department itself.
Okay. And any collaborations with foreign universities? Were there any?
Yeah, there are. One university I know is Max Planck. Other universities are also there. There are many collaborations actually. Like everyone can find in CS website actually. Everything is mentioned there.
So if you work in collaboration with a professor from that university,
you can. It's better. Like it's good for like getting PhD there.
It will be easy for you to do a PhD there. So that is one thing. And the other thing is, how did you keep yourself motivated during your gate preparation time? So they were, during most of the time it will be boring, and that initial zeal will not be there for a long time.
Initial zeal will not be there. So I would suggest one thing: whoever is starting preparation, start with some easy subjects for you, like easy or like interesting subject for you, so that you will build that habit of watching videos or preparing notes. That's one thing that's definitely required. Like if you start with very hard subject, you will find it boring, you will like find frustrating also. So start with easy subjects. And about keeping motivated, like actually my friends help a lot, like during GATE preparation. Like I used to get demotivated quite a lot, like after few tests. So then they were like, oh, no, everything will be good and there are times, so you have patience, that kind of thing. So
your friends helped you?
Yeah, friends helped me a lot.
Having good friends is important.
Yeah, that's really important. Like I was very lucky to have good friends during BTEC and during masters also.
Okay. So now looking back to the day when you had taken the decision to start your GATE preparation, now what do you think about it? So was that something
my
which changed
GATE
your life?
Preparation idea was a bit different actually, that I cannot tell in now, like that was a bit personal.
Okay.
So like but if I'll compare, like I'll tell like how I did, like I took right decision actually, because in those days I was planning for MBA.
So
like
that decision has changed your life?
Yeah, actually I was planning for MBA because like everyone were telling like how MBA there will be like money will be there a lot, so I was preparing for MBA actually. Then I switched to prepare for GATE. That switch was the correct decision I took actually.
See, for computer science students, there are jobs in the computer science area which will pay you as much as, you know, a MBA student will get. And moreover, these jobs are not so hectic like you know, management jobs.
Yeah,
if you look at an investment banker, there will be a lot of stress on him. There will be a lot of targets to reach. But for a computer science student, if you are working in a product-based company, only thing is you'll have a meeting every week and you have to just speak there and show your work, and it will be very, very... it will not be that hectic. So money will be there, and also the lifestyle, it is very lot more comfortable compared to a, you know, MBA student. So for those who are having a dilemma about going for MBA or masters, if you are from computer science, I suggest that masters in computer science is better compared to an MBA. If you are from other branches, see, the core salaries for the other branches are very, very less. So for them, if they want to have, if they want to earn more money, MBA is probably good. But the salaries in computer science are way more than what an MBA student will get. So, you know, even if in just 2-3 years, it will go into crores. You know, so that is not a big deal. And also, you know, most of the students, they end up in US. So even if Nihari is going to work for 2 years here, even if he is not going for PhD, he will definitely get a chance to go abroad through his company only, right? So don't worry about money. There is a lot of money even in this area. So if you are having any dilemma between CAT or GATE, for computer science students, I always suggest GATE. Okay. So any final words that you want to say?
Yeah, final words in the sense like for GATE preparation students, I will say like start with small targets as sir told. Then big targets will be like those are achievable. That will come with like lot of frustrations will be there also, so don't get like demoralized during preparation. I have like faced many people, they are saying that I am getting frustrated, what should I do? Don't get frustrated, things will be good with time and all. So 2-3 months of preparation, after 2-3 months of preparation, you will find yourself at good stage actually. So that's for GATE preparation students. If you are starting now, like you are fresh, don't get demoralized. And for test series also, if you are scoring less, don't get demoralized. Use some strategies on your own strategy, time management, and how to answer them well. And you will be doing well like on the go after 2-3 months also. And about doing masters in IISc or IIT, that's a big question. So that you research, like everyone is, that's a open question now. There are a lot of posts in Quora also. You can go through those posts and check about that. Take your own decision. Don't take decisions like he is saying IISc is good, I'll go for IISc, or he is saying IIT Bombay is good, I'll go for IIT Bombay. Don't take your own decision. Go through all those things like you want. Like if you want particular area to get into, then check about that area, like in this area which college is good, even if it's Kanpur or Bombay or IIS, whichever. You check about department profiles or professor profiles, which area you want to, and then decide where you want to join. Don't join like IIT Bombay, there are a lot of fun, I'll join. It's not like that. There are also the people study, they do fun also. In IIS also people study and they do fun. It's not like biased towards only study or biased towards only fun. Both, all those things are there in every college.
Okay, thank you so much for coming here and inspiring our students. Thank you so much.
I am Niranjan Sahu from Bhubaneswar. I got AIR-9 in GATE 2017 CS stream. I joined Rabindra Babula's video lecture in month of June 2016, and I started preparation from July, and I will tell his videos are very much from basics, and his motivational videos are also very good. Those videos, subject videos and motivational videos helped me a lot to get this much rank. I'll suggest my juniors join his courses. His videos are very much helpful really to crack, get good rank in GATE. And during the preparation, don't always stay motivated, don't be demoralized. And his test series are really good than other test series available. And before watching his videos, I will suggest my juniors to watch his motivational videos first. And during the end months, last 2 months of GATE preparation, always be positive. Don't be get demoralized about the questions you have appeared in test series. The test series questions are parallel to GATE papers and somehow tougher than GATE papers. That will help to attend the GATE questions in better way. And all the best to GATE 2018 aspirants. Thank you.